I am here and so excited today to speak with Amira Pollock. She is the CEO and owner, creator of Struct Club, which we'll go into details about in a second. But our conversation today is all about music and how music, especially using her platform, will help increase the energy and affect the energy level. So even decrease, if that's what you're looking for in the moment, in your classes. So before we begin, this is a series that I do on my YouTube channel. My name is Stacy, and I really try to ask best practices advice from the people I know well in the industry, or I've heard from in the industry that I really know and trust. So I can't wait to, again, have Amira here today to talk about her platform and more. A lot of great advice, especially if you teach classes that have to do with the music or use the music, or maybe you haven't tried that yet and this interview will inspire you to do that. That's like, I'm crossing my fingers for that. So to introduce Amira before I let her go off on her questions, she comes to us today from LA. So I'm so excited to have her. She's super cool like that, from Los Angeles. She's a well-known leader in the industry as the founder and CEO of what I mentioned earlier, Struct Club. It is basically this community, more than a device or an app or a platform, but it's a community of instructors who are professionally creating music-inspired fitness experiences. It debuted in 2018 during her final semester at Harvard Business School. So that in itself is just awesome. The idea and the goal was to dramatically simplify the preparation for music-based classes. And that's something we're going to talk about as well, is that can be really tough to do in order to provide a laser focus and precision in fitness classes and scale the instructor's unique style and energy, because everyone has a different taste in music. And I love this slogan for her and Struct Club, is to help instructors lead their pack. So I love this. So I'm really excited to ask first, Amira, I have to ask, from what I understand is that you've done in our past conversation some research in regards to music and how it can affect energy levels for participants in fitness classes and experiences. What do you know about that?
Yeah, and I'm happy to address and actually probably, you know, drop in the comments like a bunch of different articles for those who are interested. But first, I wanted to say just thank you for having me and having us at Struct Club on this amazing platform, and to give a shout out to Stacy, who was able to give one of the reasons she was able to give such a great introduction to me and Struct Club is because she's one of our earliest Wolfpack members and has been a huge reason why we've been able to grow and thrive as a company and being one of our champions, especially in the Seattle and Washington area, where she's a major local influencer. And so every time we were talking to various instructors in the area, they told us that we needed to meet Stacy. And so I've just been really grateful for us to be connected and to be part of the same community. When it comes to music and fitness, there's an amazing field of research around biomusicology, how we respond physically, psychologically, emotionally to music as a human species. And a subcategory of that research that's focused on exercise. So one of the studies that we come back to a lot at Struct Club, and actually one of the researchers is Kostas Karagiorgas, and he has, he's probably one of the leading experts in this space. But recently, within the past year, one of his studies in particular was highlighted in the New York Times. And one of the reasons I love this study is that it really quantifies some of the dimensions upon which music actually affects us physically and psychologically in exercise. And so what they found was they were in this study, it's called Let's Go, and it's on the NIH and Journal of Psychological Studies. So, and we'll drop it in the link below, and we'll send a few links in this recording of this video. But they found studying people who were exercising, specifically doing interval training with music, and music specifically that aligned with the tempo and the structure of the intervals, those intensity intervals, work to rest, to podcasts, and to no music at all. And guess what they found? For those of us who love music, we know this intuitively, but it's nice to see in the numbers and studies on the dimension of heart rate, on the dimension of wattage output, and then on the dimension of perceived exertion. All of those dimensions performed much higher when people were working out to music that tied along with, again, the tempo and structure of those intensity intervals. So I thought that was really, it was fascinating to see. Oftentimes we very much feel that in our exercise. And then beyond it also with the enjoyment level, it helped boost people's mood, and that they proposed could be a leading indicator into seeing whether people were more likely or not to habituate to fitness and actually make it a part of their lifestyle over time. So that's really important to us who are in, the fitness industry. Mm-hmm. We want people to be coming back again and again, not just because we want them to retain as clients, but because we're really in this to see people get healthier, get stronger, fulfill their potential, and live better lives. That music component does, in fact, enable people to help make it a habit in the long term.
I love that. No, it's so true. And I love that you said that it was a study done on people who may not all, like you had said, are music enthusiasts, like we are who teach. And I love Strut Club. I love using it. I have been using it for a really long time. But I have to say as well that the habitual, getting them to take class over and over again is the idea. It's not just that one playlist, that one time. It's that energy and that feeling that they get when their favorite song comes on, or the song that they remember a certain terrain with that they love, and they probably hear it in the car and they're like, oh, Amira's cycling class, I did this crazy hill. They like start to sweat in their car, like thinking about it. That's what's so cool. It's just like this other element of the experience. So love it. My next question is, well, kind of what I love about Strut Club is that it takes the old school method of, I remember like writing a number of what song I was going to be teaching to. I don't even think I wrote the name of the song down on a piece of paper. And then the length of the song, I know, she's like crying inside. And then my terrain that I would quickly look at, and then if I dripped sweat on it, it was over. I couldn't read it. So Strut Club took that old school method and has basically made it into something completely new. And so how does having your playlist built into Strut Club improve the ability to teach their students for instructors?
Definitely. And I think this is so interesting hearing about old school methods. Truthfully, it's 2020. I started teaching myself 3.5 years ago. And so some of those old school methods that you're talking about, I wasn't even really aware of. I was just totally coming to the industry, to my own teaching discipline, to my own classes with a fresh set of eyes, and just asking, like, where's the app for this out there? And I looked for it for 6 months. And for me, you mentioned I'm in LA. I grew up in LA and I did a lot of LA kid things growing up. I loved dancing. I loved listening. I loved playing music. I loved doing sports outdoors. But even with all that background, I found it like really hard to put together a music inspired and music choreographed class. And at the time I was teaching cycling classes. So that's what I started with. And I couldn't believe it. Like on a bike that was, really just staying in place and going to nowhere, there really is a lot of complexity that can come into the mix, even with just one piece of equipment where you're doing a very constrained set of moves. There's not like an incredible as much variability as there is with floor circuits, for example. So for me, I was just like, well, where is the one place where I can listen to my playlist through one time and be able to have one source of truth and one place to go back to in class to remind me what to do, when, exactly how long, when the next thing was coming up, have the countdown timer, have it change on the beat drop of the music, and then really be able to focus on my clients, which is what I was there to do, focus on the students, focus on their form, focus on their mood, focus on their safety, focus on their performance, and just have one glanceable place. So that was really the idea in mind and what we were trying, in answering your question, what we have manifested in the platform. So going through the Strut Club journey, you download it on the App Store. It's for free, whether it's on your phone, your iPad, your iPod Touch. And you can grab your playlist from Spotify or Apple Music. We integrate with both of those platforms. And you can basically take those playlists and you can tag the songs with, you know, maybe it's a warm-up song or a cool-down song. And if you want to get more granular than that, you can tag specific moments of songs for the starts and ends of various moves or exercises that you have. You can color code those segments by intensity. So you, if you just want a cursory glance at like, how hard should we be going? It goes from blue all the way up to red. And it's got, you know, the countdown timer and any space for special notes that you have, motivational cues, form cues, so that those can play back to you in real time. And then when all that is over, you have a running catalog of, I mean, how many folks have like lost those pieces of paper and like, oh no, I have to listen to this playlist all over again. And I've been there where I had to, you know, it's like running to a class. I used this playlist before, like a month ago, but I don't remember every single drop. Are there two drops? Are there three choruses? How long are they? I'd get that question a lot in class. And we don't always count from 30 seconds. They want to know if it's like 28 seconds, because 2 extra seconds of a sprint, like that's legit effort right there. So I just want to be able to like answer all those questions for my students and at any given point. And that's what we've put together. So it saves you time in the long run. One of the really rewarding things, pieces of feedback that we get from instructors is we help them nail their audition. They didn't feel as nervous about, oh, like, what do I have to do next? Always that question of what's coming up next? When is it coming up next? So helping them to secure new jobs or you know, being able to get a template class from a fellow instructor or a master trainer, because we have a sharing feature. So being able to share those classes with people and that timing to give them a template from where to start also saves them time. We also have enabled during COVID instructors to be able to sell and monetize their content. So what a concept. Like instructors have never been able to you know, make money for the just the playlists and curations that they put together and those ideas. And now they can, while helping another instructor get up to speed a lot more quickly. So it can be as easy as not spending any time preparing whatsoever if you want to go ahead and get material from another instructor. So saving time, being more, you know, just getting to that next level of performance, serving your clients better, and potentially even being able to make more money with Strut Club.
I love it. I love, and I do have to say, really, like she had said, we do our best to try to memorize a song, or even if you've listened to a song a million times, that nervousness and pressure of an audition, I'm sorry, but your brain is not going to work the same during that time. And so I can't imagine using it. I can totally imagine using it during an audition and being able to see, like you said, out of the corner of their eye, that color change, and knowing exactly when it's going to happen. So I know when I'm queuing through a cycling class, it basically takes it to the next level, your ability to give people that advanced knowledge of what's coming. So love hearing that. And then also my last question really was kind of, what are some of your biggest pieces of advice? Obviously Strut Club as a tool when it comes to building a playlist, but I mean, if anyone after this, we'll definitely throw a link obviously to Strut Club so people can explore below in the comments. But I also have to say to just jump on some of Amira's classes, because there are times in her playlist and her songs that I'm like, I would have never thought to do this during this time in a song. And so what are some ways you tend to encourage instructors to get creative or to look at music when they're creating their playlist?
Definitely. I think that's a great question. And thanks for the shout out. I mean, we try to do our very best. And I mean, for me, when I put playlists out there or when I put material out there, every single song is one that elicits an emotional response within me. It's something that elevates my mood or something that just really gets me going or just, you know, I hope makes the people who are riding in the room or hitting those squats, making them feel like a boss and feeling the ultimate confidence, like they can crush it. So I would apply that lesson for any instructors. You know, sometimes, especially like putting together those playlists, sometimes can be a slog. They can take a lot of time. If you can save down those songs that just really get you going, that elicit an emotional response in you, once you curate those, in addition to your clients and your your own wolf pack in your own community, just like absolutely having a great time and seeing you have a great time because you're in it and this is really sparking your energy. It also helps you build your brand. It helps people to recognize what it is that your special style is and your secret sauce is. So when you can, you know, really find those pieces, those songs, I mean, I'd forget about all the stuff that you think people like, and, you know, maybe you're not super hot on it, and really dig into the stuff that you do, because, you know, more likely than not, there are many other people, I mean, probably millions of other people out there that really love and have the same or a similar vibe and wavelength, literally as you do. So that really actually even comes back to one of my core values personally. One of our core values as a company at Struck Club is authenticity. So staying true to yourself, being true to yourself is the very best that you can do. It's probably the easiest thing for you to do too. And it's the only thing that you can exude that has your secret sauce that really nobody else is going to be able to compete with.
It's so true. And the core values of Struck Club, if you are any kind of business, should really look into them, because they're like, Struck Club knows what they're all about. They are just, I think, a leader, especially in the fitness industry, in the equality movement, and all that they do and what they speak about and what they do as a company to make instructors not only better, but their class experiences better. And like, it is pretty interesting thinking back, Amira, like you said, that we are getting there in the fitness industry when it comes to technology, but we're still behind. So hopefully someday we'll get there eventually. But I cannot thank you enough for your time. Everyone who stopped by to watch this video, if you liked today's video, definitely be sure to like the video and then subscribe to this channel for more additional content. As Amira mentioned, we're going to throw as much information in the comments below, but if you have questions about Struck Club, if you're interested in Struck Club, if you're trying to get it to match some of your classes, whether it's cycling or, as she mentioned, some of the interval training classes that you might teach, we're happy to help you be successful with that using Struck Club and beyond. So please let us know in the comments, and I cannot thank you again, Amira, enough. Follow her on Instagram, follow Struck Club everywhere, Instagram, Facebook, all of it, and download the app and just explore. Get exploring, test out the free classes, the paid classes, all of them.
Thank you so much. We're just super excited to be here, get to chat with everybody. And yes, we'll drop in links below. And we hope to, this is just the beginning of the conversation. Like, we hope to
it
stay.
Is.
Hit us up. We'll chat more.
Definitely. Thank you again, Amira. And we'll see you guys later.
Hey, Stacey. Take care, everybody. Bye.